safety on the MP.
Or Kono.
Yeah. One of the other ones I'd like to put it on, you can't because it was designed weird. It was designed to be one of those things with a lockable lock on it, but then there's no lock in it. But by doing that, there's no ability to, you would have to cut the safety in half to try to make it work. And I'm like, no.
That doesn't hurt the gun's performance of it.
No.
The safety you put in when it's never had it.
No, it'll make it safer though. The
doesn't hurt it at all.
No.
It wasn't put on by the factory.
It was put on by a gunsmith.
Yeah.
It's just fine. Works nice and sweet. Somewhere in Elastic is about $7.90 a gallon or something like that, or $7.79 or something. I've been watching the thing, this guy was living in his, he had took a Ridgeline up there with a lift kit.
Ridgeline.
And one of those little Honda trucks.
Yeah.
With the snorkel. He had a
Why? That makes no sense.
He was driving across. He was, I'm not arguing the point.
It's terrible. It has terrible. Have you watched reviews on
this
thing?
It's a car.
It is. It's got terrible four-wheel drive. It has terrible turning radius. As one guy put it, it's not much better than a RAV4.
In
terms of off-road quality.
It's not designed for that, but people are bound and determined they're going to do it. So they put, you can get the new one from the factory gives you an inch lift. Okay, I don't know if that helps you. And then another guy put a 2-inch lift kit in. Somebody else put a 4-inch lift kit in. I said, you know, this is not really even close to what
the thing was never meant to have a lift kit on it.
It's meant to be a light duty pickup.
Not even that, honestly.
It's more of a car than it is anything else. Right? And it's designed to carry or tow small loads.
Yeah.
It's basically a pilot with a bed on the back of it's what it is.
Kind of. Well.
It uses the same engine, the transmission and transfer case. A lot of the components.
Honestly, when I'm looking at videos of them driving off-road, I honestly think the pilot has a better four-wheel drive system.
It's got a better approach and takeoff, maybe. Angles are better.
I've watched the videos of the pilot going through some serious junk.
Yeah.
And then I watched the Ridgeline and it gets stuck.
Well, it doesn't have
to be. It might be that the truck weighs more than the pilot does, too.
Or the fact that it has the butt in the air, which means you don't
get
the
weight distributed right.
Right. It might not be as even balanced as it is in the pilot. Now, I'm under no illusion that the pilot is a Durango.
No.
What I wanted to get was something that was an all-wheel drive minivan, which they almost don't make. You can buy one for Toyota, it costs $9 billion.
You get a Ford Econoline. Of course, it's high up.
Mama ain't getting any of that. Econoline's not, no, it wouldn't be an Econoline. Those are junk.
Some of them are four-wheel drive.
But the, of the old Econoline in the old days.
That was weird. Like the display was freaking out.
Might be.
I've never seen it do that before. I've never seen that GoPro do that.
See, the UHF is pretty quiet.
Yeah.
Thank you. interesting that you heard that on the 3.6 frequency.
Yeah, but it was the Fargo 3.6. It wasn't Mayan 3.6.
Well,
and, 3.6
is and the 3.6 is tone.
Mm-hmm.
Because when it was up at Kenmare, it needed to be toned. So whatever sense that makes.
I think something nefariously is leaking.
In the cabinet.
Probably.
Yeah, they get some intermod in the cabinet or something.
Not in the cabinet, because the 3.6 wouldn't be having an effect of that either. Would,
you're right. That's a good
something
point.
On that frequency, because that's even on... So the 9.7 is on its own frequency, the 3.6 is on its own frequency. That's kind of a wide differentiation between frequencies.
Yeah, 146 and 147, yeah.
Yeah. Well, is it just coming in the output side or the input side?
Good question.
Is it on the input side? You get that...
What I think.
Or is it just the output side?
If it was
going through repeater, it'd have to come through the input side.
Yeah.
But then it shouldn't go when now.
Because there's an offset to it, 600 hertz or kilo, whatever it is. And there's also the tone, so.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's. Something goofy going on.
If it's cavities, it should be coming through the input side as well. If it's having an issue.
Well, it depends which side is bad. Because you tune one can to the input and one can to the receive, one to the transmit. That way, it blocks
out. 3.6 wouldn't have been that 3.6 frequency should not have been affected by cavity
and
issue.
It's too close to be a harmonic of. Especially when we're driving down the road.
Yeah.
We're not in the same tower. So intermod.
But it was having a problem the other day when I was just dialing through the frequencies.
Yeah.
So it's like a continuous something.
Or something's jamming something.
But it wasn't there a couple weeks ago because neither one of them was having that issue.
Yeah.
Got the wind.
I think it's antenna rattling. 10-meter antenna is not the best thing. I should have bought the bigger one. The bigger one would be smacking on stuff, which is why I didn't. And it would be more expensive. But I'm not convinced this antenna works for it, even though it tuned correctly. I trimmed it to fit exactly in 10 meters. But I have heard almost nothing on it, ever. I'm running it right now to see if I'll hear anything.
Okay.
looks like Art is here and Jerry is here and Milo is here.
Yeah, it's 10:20, which is usually around down the normal gear, so.
Yeah, that's after stopping at the bank. Already warmed up.
Oh, well, it's not warmed up.
It's up over. It's in the normal range, so it's producing heat. Oh, the plane's not here yet. Wind out of the northwest, and we definitely got wind. Days here, 30, 40, 50 mile an hour winds.
I don't know if it's going to be that cold. Where's that?
It's going to be kind of windy. Grubby.
35 maybe.
Yeah, well, that's a normal day.
Yeah. Helps melting though.
Yes.
Which we really need.
Yeah, nothing but snert out there now. Nothing so pretty.
If it gets up to 50, if it gets up to the mid 40s today with all this wind,
it's going to move.
And the sunlight really popping.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll melt whatever's left to be done. You can wait. Ask the government.
Okay. Air Force.
Yep. Fancy rig.
Doing something.
Mm-hmm. Big dually six pack. Mm-hmm. One ton. FPW. I gotta figure out who he is. W0FPW National. He's in town.
Look him up on
IQRZ. Like I know how to do that.
Well, the FCC's DMVs.
Was that the tire gauge? Don't want it where it's going to mess me up on trying to drive. So I had this thing earlier that said that the part was in Bismarck.
Mm-hmm. See, I you said that. It's mail for delivery now.
Yeah, I know. I just... Mm-hmm.
It's like a normal. It's locked in our useless postal system.
Huh?
It's locked in our useless postal system.
Turkey poor, yeah.
I can get is that we're at DEFCON 3. But, you know, it says they're never going to officially tell you what it is. And all the little websites that claim they know, they don't know.
When I decoded an actual message years ago at an unknown location, we had to authenticate and all the rest of that. And we shifted one DEFCON.
Oh, well.
Because we had mined Haiphong Harbor and the Russian ships were in the harbor, and we missed the fact that the Russian ships were in the harbor. We were afraid that if we sunk one of their ships, it might be kind
of torqued. Well, like the one guy says, he says, even if they switch to a different DEFCON level, there's so many sub-levels within that DEFCON level of
depending on what your status is generally, mm-hmm. and what your capabilities are. If you don't have mm-hmm. capabilities to directly mm-hmm. engage, then it may not do a lot. But if you're a mobilization outfit, it might.
And then you could throw the terrorist levels on top of that.
Well, yeah.
So you can have your max terrorist level. Craziness while only having a DEFCON 4
depending 5. On how it goes.
Yeah, and then you have they have the normal ThreatCon Delta whatever things.
It used to be Alpha Bravo Charlie Delta. I don't know what it is anymore.
Yeah, and then whatever whatever little sub level of that is and stuff. Yeah, one guy's breaking it down from when he exited the military like 3 years ago. He says, "Well, this is kind of how it was." This is what the kind of threat level would be if this is what's going on. And he was giving the guy a big breakdown on all of it. And he said they were up for reviewing and changing some of these stuff right around now. So this may not even be current. But as of 2019, this is how this would play out if this level was going on and this alert level was going on. It gives you a pretty good idea of what's probably happening.
69, we went into Big Noise Applejack mm-hmm. Delta. I have no idea what it was then. Mm-hmm. I have no idea what it is now.
Oh, yeah.
And that's been gone for
50 years now.
Well, just saying, you know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They had all kinds of... When I was in Germany... They kept changing the codes all the time. And then they would tell us to put out a red flag. What's it mean? Don't know. Pilots don't know.
Tomorrow it's a green flag.
Put out the green flag. No, 10 minutes from now it's a green flag. Oh. Or put out a green or a black. Okay. What does it mean? You don't need to know.
Well, okay.
It's good to be a cop, you know?
Stand out, sit down, fight, fight, fight.
Yeah, something like that.
Be like the Boy Scouts. I got every little flag in the air, and we don't know what any of them mean.
Well, I used to be able to do wigwag. I never learned to do semaphore. That's where you use two flags. I was good with one. That was because one was dead, one was dog, and the one that had the round patch on your shoulder was dead, and the one that had square, a rectangular patch.